One of the most well-known attractions at the Gettysburg battlefield is the Cyclorama. You'll find it in the visitors center, and it has been entertaining audiences for 129 years. News 8's Matt Barcaro gives us an up-close look.
July 3rd, 1863.
This is about the closest you can get these days to reliving the Battle of Gettysburg, surrounded by a depiction of war that comes alive.
There's a lot of drama in that moment of Pickett's charge, and there's a lot of, you know, did the fate of the nation kind of hinge on the turning point of Pickett's charge?
The Cyclorama painting captures the height of the last major Confederate advance at Gettysburg. The painter, Frenchman Paul Philippeteau, and a team of 20 artists crafted the circular painting 20 years after the battle. He included himself in the landscape and was careful not to leave out any detail.
I saw this painting for years before I realized he has the Union signal flag station on Little Round Top. He painted it on there because that's where they were on July 3rd. So you can learn a lot about the battle by studying this painting.
These kinds of paintings were the IMAX theaters of their day, and the Gettysburg Cyclorama was a big draw, especially for the men and women who lived through the war.
We have letters in our collection of, for example, one general writing to another, talking about how the painting was so realistic and that he had to go see it. And in fact, there's stories of veterans literally breaking down in tears because it was such a moving experience.
With the invention of moving pictures, though, the popularity of cycloramas faded. Someone rolled this one up in a crate and set it outside a Boston theater for years. It was damaged in a fire, rediscovered, and preserved.
This is an American treasure. This painting was so fragile and at so many times in its history almost lost.
Some 6,000 are dead, wounded.
But it is now a standing tribute to those who died at Gettysburg and gives us a sense of what it must have been like to be there. In Gettysburg, Matt Barcaro, News 8.
Now, to get a sense of how big the painting is and the system used to hang it weighs 12 and a half tons. It's 42 feet tall, and if you were to roll it out on the ground, it is longer than a football field.